The next concept is gravitational potential energy. What is this gravitational potential energy? The potential energy of a body with respect to its position above the earth is called gravitational potential energy. The potential energy of a body with respect to its position above the earth or at any point on the earth any point means we can include the depth position also is called gravitational potential energy. For every physical quantity, there is an expression. Now we are going to derive the expression for this physical quantity. Let us take a body of mass capital M from the center of it. Let us assume a point P. This point P is, we can say it as point mass. We can say that the force of attraction between these two point masses is capital G, capital M, small m by r square. We can say the distance from here to here is small r. But on the same line, just try to assume a body which is at a distance of infinity and it was traveled from A to B. Means the body was brought back to B from A. The distance from M to A is, let us say, x. This small displacement is dx. Means we did some work to move the body from A to B. The work done by a body to move it from one position to another position automatically will be stored in a form of energy. But our business is to find out the potential energy of this body in this situation. So, the gravitational force F is equal to G capital M small m by r square, we can write. The work done to move the body through a distance dx is equal to F into dx. The work done in moving the body from A to B is dw is equal to f dot dx. Because the displacement is very small, that's why the displacement is very small, we are representing in brackets. So dw is equal to, what is the f value? G capital M small m by r square into dx. Let us say this r is x, therefore dw is equal to g capital M small m by x square into dx. This is the work done to move the object from A to B, nothing but the small displacement dx. Then what is the total work done in moving the object from A to M? That is nothing but integration of the physical quantities. Therefore, for small displacement, dw is equal to f dot dx, nothing but capital G capital M small m by x square into dx. The total work done to move the object from infinity to a distance r is equal to integral dw from the limits infinity to r is equal to integral g capital M small m by x square into dx from the limits infinity to r. So we are writing this g m m as constants outside into integral infinity to r into dx by x square. Therefore, it is g m m into infinity to r under the limits x power minus 2 dx. Integral x power n dx is equal to x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Integral x power n dx is equal to x power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus some constant. In place of n we have minus 2. Therefore, work done is equal to g m m into x power minus 2 plus 1 by minus 2 plus 1 under the limits infinity to r. Therefore, this will be g m m into x power minus 1 by minus 1 from the limits infinity to r. X power minus 1 is nothing but 1 by x minus 1 if it goes up minus g m m. Therefore, it is minus g m m into 1 by x from the limits infinity to r, that is equal to work done. Therefore, the rule in the integration is we should substitute the upper limit minus lower limit. Therefore, w is equal to minus g m m into 1 by r minus 1 by infinity. Therefore, it is minus g m m by r, 1 by infinity is 0, therefore gmm into 0 is 0. Therefore, work done is equal to minus g m m by r. So, the work done in moving a body from infinity to a distance r is stored in a form of potential energy. That's why it is the expression for the gravitational potential energy. Therefore, gpe is equal to minus g capital M small m by r. This is the expression for the gravitational potential energy.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.